Now, a little below these mountains, on the left hand, lieth the country of Conceit, from which country there comes into the way in which the pilgrims walked a little crooked lane. Here, therefore, they met with a very brisk lad that came out of that country, and his name was Ignorance.
Greetings, lad.
Hello, good sirs.
Whither from?
I am from the country of Conceit.
And whither bound?
I am off to the Celestial City.
You are?
Of course!
But how do you think to get in at the gate?
Why, the same as everyone else does, of course.
But what have you to show at the gate that will cause them to open for you?
Why, because I know my lord's will, and have lived a good life. I pray, fast, pay tithes, and give alms. Besides all that, I have left my country and all that I possess in order to go on pilgrimage.
But thou camest not in at the wicket gate. Thou art likely to be called a thief and a robber.
Good gentlemen, ye be utter strangers to me. Why do you address me so curtly, seeing that I know you not?
Because we are concerned for thy welfare.
There be no need for that. You be content to follow the religion of your country, and I'll follow the religion of mine. I have a fair hope that all shall be well with both of us.
But the wicket gate is the way appointed for beginnings, no matter what our country.
Nay, but all the world knows that said gate is a great way off from the country of Conceit. I cannot think of even one man in our parts that even knows how to get there.
That should be a warning to you.
Nay, it matters not a bit. Anyone can see that we have a fine, pleasant green lane that comes directly down from our country right into the way. Actually, we have quite the jump on most folks.
There is more hope of a fool than for this man.
Aye, he is certainly wise in his own conceit.
Shall we talk with him further, or outgo him and hope that time will grant him wisdom?
He certainly feels no need of counsel at this time. I say we try to help him later, when he may be able to bear it.